Morning students, welcome back again to our channel. Today this is the next part of the video, that same chapter number 2, Microorganisms Friend and the Foe. Microorganisms Friend and Foe. So now we come to know in that case microorganisms are friend and also foe for the us. In all the previous video we have discussed about that in which activities the microorganisms are acting like us as a friend. So first was like cleaning the environment, as microorganisms at that time they're helping to us as like a friend. For the commercial use, for the medical use, for making of curd and bread. Okay, increasing soil fertility. So these are some of the reasons in which organisms are behaving, they're acting like us, like they are our friends. Making of curd and bread, medical use, commercial use, increasing soil fertility, and the cleaning for the environment. These are the all we can say very much unnecessary things are there for us in soil fertility. If they will increase the fertility of soil, the good crop will grow in that particular soil. Okay, so crops, who are eating? Only we are eating. Environment, who is living in the surroundings, who is living in the environment? We people are only living. So they are helping to us, they are cleaning the environment for us. Okay, for the medical use, the organisms are used for the medical use, for making the antibiotics and the antibodies. Now who are using the antibiotics and bodies? We people only using that we are taking the antibiotics in our body to stop, to prevent the growth of the microorganisms. Okay, then making of curd. See, curd is an ingredient which we can use mostly the all the things. So lactobacillus bacterium help us to formation from the curd to the milk to the curd. Okay, then we have seen the commercial use. From the ancient time it was like is going on the process of conversion of sugar into alcohol. It is known as a fermentation. Okay, so in 5 ways the organisms are acting like as a friend. Today we are going to learn about in which ways they are acting like us as a foe, means enemies. Kahan par enemies hai? Yes, in previous only I told you ki they are harmful for us, and yes they are helpful for us. So harmful, yes, some bacteria are harmful for us, some viruses are dangerous, and we can say they are very much harmful for us, as nowadays this virus is going on only. Okay, so now let's see what about harmful organisms. Yes, they are causing the disease in the body of the organisms. So disease causing microorganisms called pathogens. Disease causing microorganisms called the pathogens. These are known as the pathogens, as they are what they are doing, they are disease ko spread kar rahe hain. They are disease ko spread kar rahe hain. So disease causing microorganisms are called pathogens. Then we have seen disease causing the microorganism in humans. Now next is disease causing microorganism in humans. So how the disease is spreading, how the disease causes in the humans. See, there are 3 to 4 agents are there. First of all, through the food which we are eating, through the water which we are drinking, through the air, through the air which we are breathing, and from an infected person. These are the 4 reasons ki isse beta disease jo hai spread ho jayegi. First is through the food which we eat, the water which we drink, the air which we breathe, and from the infected person if we will take a direct contact with them. So disease are of 2 types. First one is a communicable disease, another one is a non-communicable disease. Yes, disease are of 2 types, communicable disease and the non-communicable disease. Now communicable disease means that kind of disease which can spread from one person to another person by the direct contact. By the direct contact, that communicable disease are like, agar direct contact aapne kiya beta infected person, so yes, the same disease will cause in your body, now you will be infected. As when we are sneezing, so thousands of bacteria are coming out. So if we will not use handkerchief, so what will happen, that same bacteria which came out from our mouth, so infected person, suppose main hu, that same bacteria, all the healthy persons will breathe the same bacteria now present in the air. So the person will breathe that air, so that's why the bacteria are goes inside when we are breathing the air. So in this way they are acting like with us as a foe only. So communicable disease we have seen, which can spread through direct contact. Non-communicable disease means that kind of disease which cannot spread from the direct contact. जो डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट से स्प्रेड नहीं होता है, दैट आर नोन एज अ नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज. नाउ लेट अस सर्च 5 एग्जांपल्स ऑफ बोथ द डिजीज, कम्युनिकेबल एंड द नॉन कम्युनिकेबल, एंड जस्ट लेट मी नो इन द ऑनलाइन सेशन. कम्युनिकेबल, फिर से बता दे रहा हूँ बेटा, दैट टाइप ऑफ डिजीज विच कैन वी कैन से इन्फेक्ट स्प्रेड बाय द डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट. नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज मीन्स दैट काइंड ऑफ डिजीज विच कैन नॉट स्प्रेड थ्रू द डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट. वो डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट से स्प्रेड नहीं होते हैं. ओके, सो अबाउट कम्युनिकेबल, अबाउट नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज, अबाउट द पैथोजेंस, यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज द कैरियर्स. अब ये कैरियर्स क्या होता है बेटा? देर आर सम एनिमल्स और इंसेक्ट आर देयर विच कैरीज द डिजीज विद देमसेल्फ, विच कैरी द डिजीज विद देमसेल्फ. ऐसे बहुत एनिमल्स, बहुत इंसेक्ट होते हैं बेटा जो अपने साथ बहुत सारी डिजीज लेते हैं. हाउस फ्लाई इज द मोस्ट कॉमन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द कैरियर. हाउस फ्लाई इज द मोस्ट कॉमन एग्जाम्पल फॉर द कैरियर. नाउ यू कैन थिंक सर वाई ओनली हाउस फ्लाई इज मोस्ट कॉमन एग्जाम्पल, बिकॉज बेटा यू हैव सीन मेनी टाइम्स, यू हैव ऑब्जर्व ऑल्सो दैट कि हाउस फ्लाई आर सिटिंग ऑन द एनिमल वेस्ट, दे आर सिटिंग ऑन द अदर फूड वेस्ट, मीन्स हर जगह बेटा बैठते हैं. सो दे आर सिटिंग ऑन दैट, पैथोजेंस विल स्टिक ऑन देयर बॉडीज. पैथोजेंस जो होंगे बेटा उनकी बॉडी पे स्टिक हो जाएंगे. नाउ दे विल फ्लाई अगेन एंड दे विल स्टिक ऑन द अनकवर्ड फूड इफ सडनली दे हैव बाइट टू यू. सो वॉट विल हैपन, जो अनकवर्ड फूड इट्स नाउ टोटली कंटेनमेंट, अभी टोटली पूरा वो पॉइजनस सब्सटेंस हो गया. एज द हाउस फ्लाई इज सिटिंग प्रायरली ऑन द वेस्ट मटीरियल ऑफ द एनिमल्स and on the other way the same house fly is now sitting on the uncovered food. So what will happen, whatever the pathogens stick with house fly on that waste, the same pathogens will enter to the food also. That same food we will suppose eat, so yes 100% we will fall sick only. Hum log sick ho hi jayenge beta, because we have eaten the food which is now, we can see it, toxic substance they have released into that. So that's why it is necessary to preserve the food very much properly. It is necessary to preserve the food necessary. Uncovered food we don't have to eat. We have to preserve the food properly, because from the food only humko disease ho sakti hai. So now there are two also we can say a type of insect which are the carries the dengue and the malaria. So female Anopheles mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito is a carrier for the malaria. Is for the malaria, and the female Aedes mosquito is spotted. Female, we can say as a female Aedes mosquito, it is for the dengue. Anopheles is for malaria, and the female Aedes mosquito is for the dengue. Now, how we have to stop? How we have to prevent the growth of the malaria? See, beta, most of the we can say mosquitoes are breed in the water only. Most of the mosquitoes are breed in the water only. So we have to take care of that thing. The water we don't have to store in the coolers, in the tires, in the flower pot. If we will store the water, so mosquitoes will start breeding into that. If they will start the breeding, so they will increase. So what will again they will bite us, and we will be humko malaria beta ho sakta hai. So we have to keep our surroundings always dry and surroundings always clean to stop the growth of the microorganisms. So this was about it, how they are harmful to us in the many ways that disease they are causing. On the page number 24 and 25, two tables are given. In that, some name of the diseases and how they are spreading from the air, from the water, from the food. What is the mode of their transmissions? Okay, mode kya transmissions ke beta. What are the preventive measures we have to give? Suppose we can take the disease name is corona. Okay, now how it's spreading from one person to another person. ठीक है, पहले तो ऐसा ही हो रहा था, एक पर्सन से दूसरे पर्सन, अगर इफ इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन मीट्स विद अ हेल्दी पर्सन, सो सेम वायरस विल गो इनटू दैट ऑल बॉडी, सो दैट पर्सन इज आल्सो नाउ इन्फेक्टेड. नाउअडेज व्हाट इज नाउ, इट आल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द एयर. सो एयर एंड द डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेक्ट बोथ आर द मोड ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन. प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स, यस वी हैव टू वियर मास्क प्रॉपरली, हैंड सैनिटाइजर वी हैव टू डू अगेन एंड अगेन, वी हैव टू इंक्रीज आवर इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम. So likewise, this I have given the example which is the current situation now. But in textbook, the other name of disease are written, how the mode of transmission, what the preventive measures we have to give, that all the things are mentioned over there. So just read it once and keep all the things in mind. If you're not able to understand anything, just let me know. Just ask from me on the online session. Okay. Food poison. You have listened bit of food poisoning. Now what is the food poisoning? Yes, just now only we have studied about कि yes food poisoning जो है बेटा, food poisoning से क्या होता है? If that housefly sitting on that animal waste and other kind of waste, they will sit on the uncovered food, that same we will eat. So if we will eat the contaminated food, if we will eat the food which is now has a toxic substance which released by the house fly, तो उससे बेटा हमको food poisonous हो सकता है. If it will हम बेटा उसमें ill भी हो सकते हैं, sometimes death भी हो जाती है किसी person की अगर food poisonous बहुत ज़्यादा हो जाए तो. Food preservation, yes it is very much necessary to preserve the food. If we will not store the food properly, if we will not preserve the food properly, so what will happen? The number of we can say disease will increase. That's why again and again we are telling ki don't eat food from the outside, don't eat food from the stalls, eat all the items from the home only. That is safe for you because beta mosquitoes uspe kab baithenge we don't know even. ठीक उस पर बैठ गए होंगे उन्होंने पैथोजन्स रिलीज कर दिए होंगे. नाउ द फूड इज टोटली व्हिच टॉक्सिक फुल ऑफ सब्सटेंस इट इज, सो दैट सेम फूड वी विल नॉट ईट. इफ यू ईट तो हमको डिजीज होगी, फूड पॉइजनस हो सकता है. तो प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ फूड इज वेरी मच नेसेसरी. नाउ सम ऑफ द कॉमन मेथड्स आर देयर फॉर द फूड प्रिजर्वेशन. नाउ लेट्स सी कि व्हिच मेथड्स आर देयर. यस हियर आर सम ऑफ द वेज ऑफ द फूड प्रिजर्वेशन. द केमिकल मेथड प्रिजर्वेशन बाय कॉमन सॉल्ट, प्रिजर्वेशन बाय शुगर, प्रिजर्वेशन बाय ऑयल एंड विनेगर, heat and the cold treatment, storage and the package. These are the six methods on which we can preserve the food properly. So these six methods we have to follow in our day to day life also, as you people are following only. That's why the food is preserved properly at your home and you store it properly. Chemical method. So what is the chemical method? Salt and the ethyl oil are the most we can say common method are there to preserve the food. You have seen if mangoes you have purchased from outside, so within 3 to 4 days मैंगो सब बेटा आप नहीं खा पाओगे बिकॉज दे आर टोटली रॉट नाउ. बट येस इफ द सेम मैंगो पिकल योर मदर इज प्रिपेयरिंग एट द होम, इट विल वो बेटा लॉन्ग टाइम तक चलती रहती है. वाई इट इज सो? बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रॉपर प्रिजर्वेशन. इन डेट दे आर एडिंग ऑयल एंड अ सॉल्ट. वॉट इट विल द बैक्टीरिया विल नॉट लिव इन द डेट काइंड ऑफ एटमोसफियर, सो दे विल नॉट डू एनी काइंड ऑफ हार्म. दे विल नॉट हार्म द डेट काइंड ऑफ फूड इन इट बिकॉज दे आर नॉट एबल टू सर्वाइव इन दिस एटमोसफियर वेयर the oil and the salt is present. So these are known as the preservatives. Preservatives bol sakte hain. These are also used in the jams, we can say to check in the jams also, in the squashes also. By this adding this we can easily check the growth of the microorganisms. Preservation by the common salt. Preservation by common salt means common salt we are adding to the meat, to the fish. So what will happen is it will स्टॉप द ग्रोथ ऑफ द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स और इसको लंबे समय तक बेटा हम लोग रख सकते हैं एज वी हैव एडेड द सॉल्ट इन टू द सेम. सो दिस वॉज द प्रिजर्वेशन बाय द कॉमन सॉल्ट. प्रिजर्वेशन बाय द शुगर. प्रिजर्वेशन बाय शुगर मीन्स दिस इज यूज मेथड इन द जैम्स. शुगर द जैम्स वी कैन यूज इन द जेलीज इन द स्क्वैशेस आर प्रिजर्व्ड बाय द शुगर ओनली. शुगर रिड्यूस द मॉइस्चर. शुगर रिड्यूस द मॉइस्चर एंड इट विल रिड्यूस द ग्रोथ ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया विच स्पॉइल द फूड. वो शुगर उसका मॉइस्चर बेटा रिड्यूस कर देगा तो उसमें क्या होगा, बैक्टीरिया की ग्रोथ इतना स्टार्ट नहीं होगी. प्रिजर्वेशन बाय ऑयल एंड द विनेगर. यस अगेन द सेम यूज ऑफ ऑयल एंड विनेगर प्रिवेंट द स्पॉइलेज ऑफ द पिकल्स. पिकल्स की जो स्पॉइलेज ऑफ बेटा वो आप स्टॉप करते हैं. सो इन दिस एटमोसफियर द बैक्टीरिया नॉट एबल टू लिव द ऑयल एंड विनेगर इज प्रेजेंट. दैट्स व्हाई यहाँ पे फूड जो है बेटा लॉन्ग टाइम तक वो हम लोग यूज कर सकते हैं. हीट एंड कोल्ड ट्रीटमेंट. हियर एग्जांपल ऑफ मिल्क आई वांट टू गिव कि यू हैव सीन योर मदर व्हेन शी इज बॉइलिंग द मिल्क आफ्टर दैट अगेन उसको बेटा कोल्ड करके प्रॉपर टेम्परेचर फ्रिज में रख देते हैं. व्हाई वी आर डूइंग हॉट एंड कोल्ड, उसको पहले गर्म किया. सपोज बैक्टीरिया आर प्रेजेंट इन द मिल्क, सो इफ यू विल हीट द बैक्टीरिया दे विल किल, बेटा किल हो जाएंगे. एंड अगेन वी हैव कोल्ड एट द सेम मिल्क एंड वी हैव कैप इन द प्रॉपर टेम्परेचर, उससे कोई बैक्टीरिया की ग्रोथ वहां पर नहीं होगी. लास्ट वन इज द स्टोरेज एंड द पैकेज. यस दिस वन इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउअडेज यू हैव सीन द वेजिटेबल्स, द ड्राई फ्रूट, नाउ दे आर सेलिंग इन द एयर टाइट कंटेनर्स. इफ दे विल सेल द ऑल दिस थिंग एयर टाइट कंटेनर्स, तो वहां पर कोई माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स का ग्रोथ होने का चांस होता ही नहीं है. सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द कॉमन मेथड्स फ्रॉम विच वी कैन प्रिजर्व द फूड. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड अबाउट इन विच वे द ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर फॉर फॉर अस, लाइक दे आर स्प्रेडिंग द डिजीज, दे आर स्पॉइलिंग द फूड एज वेल, बट वी आर ऑल्सो हैविंग द मेथड्स टू स्टॉप द स्पॉइलेज ऑफ द फूड एंड वी हैव टू फॉलो द सेम इन आर डे टू डे लाइफ ऑल्सो. So whatever doubt if you're having related to this video, you can ask from me on the online sessions. Thank you and have a nice day.